Hey guys, Rory from ANS Gear. Today we're going to look at the electronic frame for the BT guns. So we've got one here that is designed for the BT4 markers. So any of the markers that fall under the BT4 category, this electronic frame will work for them. Couple things about the frame. It's going to run on a 9-volt battery. On the back side here, you've got your on and off button down here at the bottom, and then you've got your indicator light up above it. It does come with 5 firing modes. It comes with your standard semi-auto. It comes with a PSP ramping set to 10 or 13 balls per second and an NXL full auto mode at 10 and 13 balls a second as well. So those are your 5 firing mode options. The firing rate is not adjustable. It is preset in either of the 2 ramping or full auto modes. It's either 10 or 13 balls a second. And then obviously your semi-auto is semi-auto. So you can't adjust it or fine-tune adjust it to be like 12.5 or 9.6 or whatever you want to put it at. You are kind of locked in with their predetermined rate of fire. But if you're not playing tournaments, it really doesn't matter. Inside the box, you're going to get your extra set of screws should you need them. And then also your instruction manual, if I can get out of there. Right here, it's going to talk to you about how to set your firing modes and how to change things. What it does not tell you inside there is how to install it. So we're going to do a quick run through on how to install it into the gun. So in front of me, I do have a BT4 Delta. Now this one is a little different in that the way the stock works on this gun, it does cover up the screws that you're gonna need to take the frame off. So we will need to extend the stock out to get to the screws in this particular model. So the first thing we're gonna do is, obviously we're gonna make sure the gun is degassed, that the tank is not on it, that the gun is not in the cocked position, just safety stuff. Wanna make sure that your gun is always in a safe to work on mode or platform before you do work on the gun. So we know that it's like that. When you pull the trigger, nothing's shooting, we're not in safety. So we know the gun is decocked and degassed. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna remove the ASA off the bottom. So take the 2 screws out that hold this on. And when I take these out, you will notice that, let me push these up here real quick so you can see them, that these 2 screws are a different length. One is longer than the other. Short one's gonna go at the front, long one is gonna go at the back. Make sure you don't switch those up. Now we're gonna extend the stock out, all the way out, so that you can get to the 2 screws. Now here's our screws right there, and we'll see them on the other side as well. The side that has the rounded head on the top of it is the side that you want to unscrew. The other side here has a squared off side or edges to it. Those will not unscrew. They are just, they're the opposite side of the screw. It's what the screw threads into. So don't try to unscrew that side or you just end up ruining your gun. So we're gonna unscrew from here. We're gonna take these out. Now these 2 screws here are the same length, so you don't need to worry about mixing them up or anything. So we'll pull both of those out. You can see them right there. And these are our 2 ASA screws. Now, the piece that this threads into, we do need to remove it also. So we can actually just take our Allen key and push through from the other side, make sure that they come out, and you can see them right there. Okay, so this actually threads into this piece, and that's what makes our entire screw right there. So we'll set those down. Once these 2 screws are off and the bottom is off, your frame is just gonna pop right off. Okay, comes off super easy. Take our new frame, gonna put it on, make sure that our holes and everything is gonna line up. So slide it into position where you know it's gonna line up right. Now what I do is for the first part I put in is the piece that the screw threads into. So I'm gonna put those through, or my holes on the back here. I'm gonna line it up. I'm gonna push my screw in so that it locks into the frame. Gonna make it easier to then just put our threaded side in and tighten it down. Now I always hold from the other side so that that piece doesn't pop out if I'm putting any pressure on the screw here. So we're going to tighten that down. Go to our other one. Make sure that everything lines up right. If your screw doesn't thread in right away, you might just need to readjust the frame a little bit. Like this one is not wanting to go in on me. So I'm going to look in there and see where I'm out of alignment and try to line my screw up. There we go. Just so everything matches up. So we're going to tighten that down. And like with most things, you don't need to over tighten. Just make sure you've got a good snug fit and that will be plenty fine. Long screw in the back, short screw in the front. Line them up with the holes and thread them in. And just give it that final cinch. One there. And one there. And there we go. Now we've got our electronic frame set up on there. We can put our stock back into the closed position and we're ready to go. We can choose our firing modes, throw a battery in, and we're ready to shoot. It's a very simple install, very quick as you can see, and it's going to give you the firing options that you are lacking in just the original mechanical version. So if you're looking forward to or looking to add some firepower to your gun, check these out. The electronic frames from BT. They fit all the BT4 model guns. They're available through the website. Order yours now through ansgear.com.